right, here we go. OU against MSU. The battle of the green and white.
Yeah.
15:30 left here. No points scored so
It really falls off. misses the team kick. It's like OU wins the rush. They have seven balls. And makes a huge catch. MSU has all the momentum right now. But OU has all the balls. And another hit on by MSU, Max Stockholm. Sorry if I pronounced the name wrong. That's two captains on OU that are down so far.
Jones gets a big hit on MSU.
MSU down to 7 players, OU has 4. Gets Terrence Checkett back in. OU's president.
You get off just after the rush, so I don't think they had too many catches.
You can't do that
one. OU is back to 5 players and MSU has 7. This game could go either way at this point. Barry Butler trying to secure team catch and gets taken out. Huge momentum swing for OU. It's now down to 5 versus 5. MSU's next throw put them on a 10 count. Both teams are even. OU gets another hit. Number 15 is Hunter Hempries making big plays in the left corner for OU. Setting. MSU has to go up.
5, 6, 7, 8. And we got 10 minutes left in this half. Now just 1-0 MSU.
Team sequence of plays.
DQ
makes a crazy catch in the middle between his legs. And then another player on MSU gets Terrence Checkett out in the corner. That leaves Judson Jones and Caleb Arnold left for OU. Number 32 for MSU is Adam Arnold making some big plays, controlling the left side for that team.
I think we got a balls over.
Balls over MSU.
On MSU, so. Big momentum swing. Let's see if OU can convert here, take advantage of this balls over.
So it looks like Judson Jones is going to survive from that. The hit from Adam Arnold does not count. The one thing about Caleb Arnold, he's really known for his catching, but I think he's a really underrated thrower as well. He's really developed in the last couple years. MSU right now is Josh Kramer on the left side. You'll need to see a big play. Can't throw from OU misses. MSU gets one ball. Throw until they get 3 balls, so we're going to see Caleb and Judson going up making team throws for a little bit here.
They got reset.
2 reset throws from them, and MSU pushes up. Adam Arnold, another big hit on the left side, takes out Judson Jones. He's having a hell of a point.
Nice. That looks like a catch there.
reset throws until they find a good opportunity. They know Caleb can catch, and he'll do it if they give him a chance. He's looking for him. Caleb takes out one. Number 69 at MSU takes out Jacob Bishop.
And we got even shot clocks. Both teams are 5 feet.
Close call there. Caleb almost takes out Adam.
MSU.
Gonna try to figure out a game plan to take out Arnold. Solo survivor.
Out of timeout.
We saw Caleb clutch one at the Buckeye Showcase, 1-4 on Cincinnati. Let's see if he can do it.
Ref is mad.
First throw. Caleb is going to sit on his back line with all seven balls. The rest of the seven. At MSU, we have Josh Kramer, Adam Arnold, and a freshman. Rookie, better right there. Both teams making resets. MSU is going to force Caleb Arnold to come up. Caleb gets a hit on Josh Kramer, their captain. Two players left. Caleb Arnold versus Adam Arnold and a rookie for MSU. Matt Baraball is the rookie. Minutes left in the first. Really good effort by Caleb to get that point. He almost had the 5-1. He got it down to 1-2. Also, just a really good team throw by MSU on that last throw.
Great, 10 green balls. That makes balls easier. Yeah. As we win.
Page. making some quick throws. Only 6 minutes left in this first half. They know they're going to have to go quick to get a point. If time runs out and all players are still on the court, or there's a player on each team, then nobody scores a point at the end of the half. Butler takes out Janowskis. Missed opportunity on that catch. Another missed catch.
Somebody float one through the back. Got out of the back line there.
You can tell that OU wants this point, but they're going to have to slow down if they don't want to lose another one before halftime. If MSU goes up 3-0 before half, it looks like it might be game.
25 right there.
Set both teams' shot clocks to zero. One from each team. That's all you can do. NCAA's played with 10 balls. They were playing with 12. Looks like two green balls must have rolled on the court on accident and nobody noticed. So the refs stopped the game to make sure that we were only playing with 10.
Put them in the wagon.
Taking one ball from each team seems like the only fair way to do it. That leaves MSU with two balls. That means they will not have a shot clock at the start of this next point, the start of the resumption of the clock.
And here they come.
3, 2, 1.
Looks like OU connected there on one throw.
OU's going to have to be real aggressive to get this point before the half. MSU's going to try and play this as slow as they can. Gerling makes a reset on the right side.
Not exactly sure how much time is left in the official time. I think it's around 3 minutes, though. Brett's got the official clock, I believe. Right down yonder.
Team throw on OU. You can't have this if you want to score. MSU's back at the six balls. They've taken control over the point. Gerling hits Hunter Humphreys on the left side. Team together to get this last point.
10 seconds, 15.
14.
What did you guys have?
13.
Everyone's still wow, you guys are bad.
You're bad.
Fair enough.
I'm glad you placed the ball.
13 seconds left on the clock is the official time.
14 seconds.
14.
14?
There you go.
Less than six players on the court, each team has to make a throw within 10 seconds. Because OU only has one player left and 14 seconds, they need to make one throw. And then he doesn't have to make any more the rest of the game. MSU, I think, has five balls. They're going to have to put all five on this kid to get this point. What do you think, Sam? Can you survive? He's got three balls set up at his feet in the corner, holding one more. He's trying to get some extra protection. He's going to block with one ball. He's got one more in the middle of the court. He should be holding two.
Your MSU, how many balls are there?
This first one he's going to block. I think I make a reset, and then I make a team throw on the second one. That was a mistake on OU's part. OU called the timeout, so their shot clock reset to 7 seconds instead of zero. So OU only had 3 seconds to make a throw before MSU. So OU gets the balls over, shot clock violation called on them. MSU gets all the balls. It's going to be real hard to survive after this point.
4 seconds.
4 seconds left. MSU's going to have to run up and get a kill in 4 seconds. Miss. They
call time.
OU call timeout.
I'm not sure what's happening. OU may have called a timeout. 2 seconds left, timeout by OU. So because OU called a timeout, all the balls that were in the air when the timeout was called were live. And those first few balls that were thrown missed, and OU will keep those balls after the timeout. So the player on OU is going to have a couple seconds to be in, to defend himself in the corner while MSU tries to go up and make a kill. Looks like OU is going to survive this point. Really good timeout call by OU. MSU should have just thrown all their balls right away as soon as they got them. It looks like one of those balls did hit him, but OU caught a timeout right before it was thrown. And because the ball was not in the air, it was not considered live, so it did not count. I'm confused. Does OU not get to keep any balls? Alright, so I made a mistake. OU did not call the timeout before the balls were thrown. So he has zero balls. And they all miss. He survives. End of the half. 5 minute halftime. Scores MSU to 2, OU 0.
How's it going, Adam?
Going good. How are you doing, Dylan?
Good. How are you feeling after the first half?
You know, we started out with some good pace. We're looking for ball control. So we've gotten that so far. You know, it's minimizing the gaps between the people, making sure those throws are short and sweet, hitting our spots, low the knees, shoulders high and above. You know, making sure that we can hit Ohio, those catches. We know that they can get down, they can get low, they can take those catches in. Just making sure, you know, that we're hitting those spots where they can't easily catch it. You know, catch them off guard. We're throwing our transition balls perfectly right now. You know, this is right where we want to be.
For sure. You guys are looking real great. At the end of that second point, you were making a lot of big plays on that left side. What was going through your head? Were you guys comfortable that you were going to get it, or did you think Caleb had a chance?
You know, coming into the game, we knew Caleb was going to be a hard out. You know, he's a good catcher. He can definitely challenge us. You know, he can bait us into making those bad throws on our part. So just in getting him out, making sure that, you know, we're getting him in transition when we know he's running back, he might be off balance, making sure he's not in the back line, making sure, you know, if he does have a ball in his hand, it's up in the air, so we catch him off guard. If he is on the back line with the ball, we're not necessarily throwing at him without a team throw. Because we know he can make that big catch to turn the tide, and we don't want him to do that.
So. For sure, Adam. Good work that first half. Good luck in the second.
Thank you.
All the way back to their back line.
Good one!
OU has four balls pushing up. Butler takes out Caleb in the middle. Can't go up alone if you don't have any help. Curling a big snipe on Max Stoffel on the right. MSU controlling all the momentum right now. Five players left on OU. Next throw is going to be a 10 count.
His left foot was no longer touching the black line. He was out. Correct. But.
Yeah.
Janowskis throws a long catch to MSU side.
And Kramer threw one off the rush too. He got somebody.
OU has all the balls right now. They're going to have to build on this momentum to come back. MSU sitting nice and comfortable over there on the left side. They know they don't need to rush. They're looking for long points. Alec Dean, big hit on Max Stoker.
Michigan State takes this point to be a 4-0 lead, which means it's a running clock after that, so no stoppages of play. We'll just keep it going.
His name is Max Stackle. It's not Ockle or Ockle. It's Stackle. I apologize, Max. MSU are sitting back, letting the rookies do the work. Going to finish off the point and wear out Caleb Arnold so they can't come back in the future. Team throw for MSU. Four misses. Caleb Arnold survives. I think Caleb should just step out. Caleb steps out, they get the point, and they save time. They're not going to have time to come back if he survives. Regardless, I don't think they can score 3 points now anyway. Looks like Jack Gerling is the final hit on Caleb. Another dominant point by MSU.
Right.
Score is 4-0. That means a rolling clock will be initiated. So the game clock will continue to run until the game is over, unless the team calls a timeout. The point of this is to try to get the games over quickly that are just too one-sided. And, well, this one is for MSU.
Technical upset.
It is? But MSU, well, I don't know, actually, MSU ratings change each match. It's a little difficult to see today. But MSU is their first tournament, so they don't have any points for this season. But they will move up the rankings today. Now they can beat over Penn State for that number one spot.
I think Penn State's the real deal in the East Coast. They went 4-0 at their first tournament. I would love to see more team integration in the NCAA. Most teams just stay within their own region. Props to MSU for coming down here. Also, we need some more tournaments held in the Michigan region. Our first one is at WMU on November 4th, I believe.
trying to put something together. Five players versus four.
Good play by Ethan.
Or, I'm sorry, John.
and he's sitting in the back on their knees, waiting for the ball from MSU.
Hey, hey!
Thank you.
gets hit. OU gets the point. That's going to make the final score. MSU 4, OU 2.
All right, I have Captain Jack Gurley from MSU. Jack, how are you feeling after that match?
Good. I like how our team performed. They executed pretty well. Even though we lost the last 2 points, our freshmen and our rookies really stepped up. So.
Yeah, I think so too. Even when you guys had your rookies in at the end, you guys were still dominating.
Yeah.
What do you think the final score, 4-2 over OU, says about Michigan versus the Ohio region?
I think we're still dominant.
You think so?
That's my thing, yeah.
When are you guys going to host the tournament?
That's not my end of the...
Good job playing, man. You guys look pretty dominant out there.
Thank
Keep it up.
Thank you.